Hello, my name is Ellie Lotus-Maki, and for my final explorations, I decided to explore colors and moods through Procreate. So when I first came up with the idea of doing colors and moods, I wasn't really sure how I wanted to implement it. I first thought of doing like real life painting on a canvas or even photography. But as I was talking with my parents, my dad told me that he had just got a new iPad. And the first thing that came to my mind was Procreate. And I've always been interested in it. I've always wanted to become better at it. So I thought this was a perfect time for me to learn a lot more about it and become a better digital painter, or I guess a digital artist. Because basically Procreate, as most of you guys might already know, it's an app on the iPad where you can digitally create drawings or animations. And there's so many things to discover about this. And as you can see through like the photo that I put on the right side, there's so many different paintbrushes, colors, elements, everything to this that I just wanted to discover more about. So basically, for the first thing I did was to find a few colors that I wanted to explore for this, my final product. And I chose to do red, yellow, and blue just because I think these are the most like, I guess, basic colors that you would connect to an emotion, but I thought that they also blended really well together. And I also didn't want to have too many colors, and I didn't want the whole entire drawing to look like an enormous rainbow or anything, so I just stuck with these colors. And it's pretty self-explanatory, but the red is for anger, yellow is for joy, and the blue is for sadness. So just a side note, the one thing I learned throughout my entire process is the importance of using different layers. And they're important to use when you're using any program, and we've been taught that throughout freestyle, but the same definitely goes for Procreate, and I would say even more so, because if you put everything on the same layer, you won't be able to really make changes, and you have a lot more freedom when you put every single little detail on a different layer, because you can easily hide layers that you don't like and recreate layers. And it just made it, I realized how easy it makes the process when you put everything on separate layers. And it's also, it gives you a lot more freedom. So here's my infographic. I'm gonna go more into the steps in the next slides, but here's my infographic. So the first thing I did was sketching and planning for my final product. On the left side, I have a drawing that I made before I even started doing digital drawing at all. I wanted to kind of visualize it by painting on hand because for me it's easier to kind of do something with my hands and to be able to actually see. I mean, I guess it's the same for the digital thing, but it just makes it, I don't know, it was just easier for me to be able to actually mix the paints by hand. So I did that, and I did that using the colors that I was planning on using for my final product. And then on the right side, I have two images. These are on my own, but I found them on Pinterest, and it kind of inspired the style that I wanted to use for my final product. So here's my process that I have from my screenshots of my drawing on Procreate. And as I was drawing, I kind of realized that I was using kind of Japanese style, which was really interesting because I've been watching a lot of anime lately. And so I think that kind of inspired a lot of the drawing. But basically, Japanese art has a lot of natural and nature aspects to it. So when I first drew the tree, I realized that I was kind of implementing that into my own drawing without really even noticing it. And then I wanted to keep that going. So I drew some mountains and the sun. And the red is kind of for fire, I guess. But yeah, these are my some process photos. You can see how each one has some new layers to it, and how they're all the little details are on their own separate layers. And yeah, here's my final product. You can tell that the guy on the left side is the guy that represents sadness, and then joy and anger. So yeah, but thank you for watching, and I hope you guys all have a great summer. Thank you.